Assalamualaikum. Good morning, students. How are you doing today? I believe you are pretty much well. I'm also pretty much good by the grace of Almighty. So I am here today, grade 4 students, subject English for today. So please take your textbook, copy and pen in front of the brought you by Bangladesh Online Primary School. Are you ready? I believe you are ready in front of myself. Please never hesitate to share the class with your friends and family members and relatives. Okay? So that they can enjoy the class with you. I'm Raihana Hawk, head teacher of Bajgari 1 Government Primary School, Bhuro Kishoregonj. You know me very well because I'm always taking English class. So, my dear students, today's our topic is, please, everybody look at me, what I am doing. So our topic is write while first, write while one. We have another class, write while two. So this is the first class, write while one. So please look at the screen carefully. What can you see? One boy is running and her mother standing behind him. He is a boy like you. He goes to run and his mother behind him. The curtain is blowing. Curtain is blowing. Maybe some wind blowing the curtain. So read and say, write while one. At first, I read out, after that you also repeat after me. Shihab lives in Dhaka. Where? Shihab lives in Dhaka. One day, he is at home with his mother. They are talking. Suddenly, it starts raining. It starts raining. Shihab runs to the window and closes it. His mother is very happy. Shihab lives in where? Dhaka. One day he is at home with his mother. Where? With his mother. Where? At home. They are talking. They are talking with his mother and boy and his son. Suddenly it starts raining. Suddenly what happened? Raining. Shihab runs to the window and closes it. Where Shihab runs? Windows. Near of the windows and closes it. His mother is very happy. His mother is very happy. You can see after completing the sentence, we put full stop. This is a normal statement. One day, this is, after that, we see here a comma. He is at home with his mother. After completing the sentence, the end of the part, we put here full stop. You know very well. This is a punctuation mark, comma and full stop. The previous class we have learned about it. They are talking. This is a statement and we put here full stop. Suddenly there is a comma. It starts raining. After ending the sentence we give again full stop. Shihab runs to the window and closes it. After completing the sentence, any sentence, we put here full stop. His mother is very happy. His mother is very happy. So, please look at the scenery. Use of capital letter and full stop. Sentence always start with a capital letter. Sentence always start with the capital letters. With the capital letters. Names of people and place also start with the capital letters. We use the full stop to end statements. Use the full stop to end statements. Suppose, for example, my name is Mitu. You can see the first letter is start with capital letter, uppercase letter. This is uppercase letter. This is lowercase letter. Uppercase, lowercase, capital letter, small letter. Uppercase, lowercase, capital letter, small letter. Uppercase means capital letter. Lowercase means small letter. Any statement start with a capital letters. After that, when you get any proper noun, naming words, then you have to use capital letter as well. Okay? The first letter, the sentence, when you start any sentence, the first letter must be capital or uppercase letter. And the proper noun or naming words, you have to write down anywhere capital letter. Start with a capital letter. Mitu, it's a naming words. It's a girl's name. Mitu. 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 It's a girl's name. So we write down here the first letter, capital letter. And after completing the sentence, we put here full stop. I'm from Dhaka. It's also naming words. Dhaka is our capital city. Dhaka is our capital city. So we write down the word by the capital letter. I'm from Dhaka. Read the paragraph in activity A again. Underline the capital letters and the circle the full stops. Okay. So what is the capital letter? Shihab. Shihab, the naming words. After completing the sentence, the full stop, Dhaka. Dhaka is also capital letter. Dhaka. D. And one. First letter is capital letter, and his mother as a capital letter. It starts raining. Day, the first letter T is the capital. T is capital. After that, talking. There is full stop. Then you can see from the screen, S is the capital letter because it's also naming words and also start with these words. Capital letter S and full stop is after completing the sentence. You make circle. His mother is very happy. His first letter is H. H is capital letter and the after that the full stop. Okay, have you clear? I hope so. So again, read out sentence start with a capital letter. So any sentence start with the capital letters. Name of people or naming words, place also start with a capital letter. We use the full stop to end the statement. You are all right. So suppose my name is Mitu. I'm from Dhaka. Every sentence completing, we put here full stop and naming words start with capital letters and it's also capital letters. Now I have exercise for you. Add capital letters and full stop to the paragraph. Now I'm going to read out the text. Manik is 6 years old. He has a sister, her name is Meena. She is 5 years old. Manik and Meena lives in Sylhet with their parents. So try to complete the sentence in your copy, please. You get 1 minute. After that, I will show the screen. three, which one is capital letter? Will be capital letter. Okay, I hope, I believe you have completed. Money, the first letter is a capital letter, it will be capital letter, years old. Put, full stop. He, capital letter, has a sister. Sister, full stop. Her name is H, is capital letter, name is Meena. Meena, first letter will be capital M. Put, full stop. She is 5 years old. She is 5 years old. Put, full stop. Money, M, capital letter, and Meena, capital letter, live in Sylhet, capital letter, S, and with their parents. Put, full stop. So, you can see, Mani, this is the first letter, so you write down here, capital letter, years old, after completing the sentence, you put here, full stop, and he must be, H is capital letter, and give here full stop, after that, H will be capital letter, Meena will be also capital letter, after that, you give here full stop. She, the master, first letter is S, will be capital letter, 5 years old. After completing the end of the sentence, you put here full stop. Money, this is the naming words and also start with these words. So, you have to write down the capital letter and Meena as well. Live in Sylhet, the capital letter will be because it's a place with their parents. Put full stop. Now, I'm going to next place. In the meantime, we have known where you gave the capital letter and full stop. Now, for using. Now, look at the screen. Hi, I'm Rina. I'm Ria. What's your name? I'm Shanta. I'm in class 4. Are you in class 4? Yes, I'm again. Hi, I'm Ria. What's your name? I'm Shanta. I'm in class 4. Are you in class 4? Yes, I'm. You can see here the question statement. You put here question mark. This is called question mark. Question mark. Question mark and question mark. What happened? Next, go to the next slide. Use of question mark. Use of question mark. When we want information, we ask a question. Question, we use a question mark at the end of this sentence. When we want information, someone information, we ask a question. We ask a question. We use a question mark at the end of this sentence. Do you go to school? Do you go to school? Who is your teacher? Who is your teacher? Do you go to school? Where are you, teacher? Look activity again. Again, copy the questions in your exercise book. Okay, this is a activity 1. A. Hi, I'm Ria. This is the full stop. What's your name? This is a question statement. You have to give a question mark. I'm Shanta. I'm in class 4. Are you in class 4? This is also a question sentence. You have to put question mark here. Let's have a look. Write the sentence in your exercise book. Add capital letters and question mark. Question mark where? After completing the sentence. Do you live in Rashari? Please. Do, you have to write down, must be capital letter. Rashtra, it's a naming words, place name. So you have to write down the R capital letter. After that, you have to put question mark. Alright, marvelous. Is. Second one, where do you play? Must be capital letter and then put question mark. Alright. Is, must be I, capital letter, me too. This is the naming words. You have to put capital letter, your friend. What? Question. How old are you? Is, must be capital letter and question mark. End of the sentence, question mark. Can you use a computer? Can? First letter is, will be must, capital letter. And after that, you have to put question mark. Alright. W, you have to make the uppercase letter. After that, question mark. Where are you from? Do you live in Rajshahi? Where do you play? Is me to your friend. How old are you? Can you use a computer? Where are you from? Okay. Dear students, today's class I have discussed with you how to use capital letter and full stop and question marks. I think everything is clear to you because this is the repeat class. So don't hesitate. Okay. What's your homework? What is your homework? I will give you two statements. You have to write down with capital letters and full stop and also two question sentences. So how many? Four. You have to write down four sentences. One is normal statement. You have to put capital letter as well, full stop. After that, you have to write down question mark, capital letter with question sign or question mark. Okay. So I want to say happy learning and keep practicing. Practice makes a man perfect. And take care. Till then, bye. Next class, see you.